How does the Oncotype DX test lead to more personalized breast cancer treatment? Here are some important thoughts. Over this past decade or more, the treatment of all breast cancers has changed significantly. This is particularly true when it comes to estrogen receptor positive stage 1 and stage 2 breast cancers, as well as changes going on in the treatment of ductal carcinoma in situ. There is no question that in estrogen receptor positive breast cancers, the utilization of the Oncotype DX test has become an important and invaluable tool. As you will recall, there are three types of recurrence scores that can be obtained. A low-risk recurrence score, which means that a patient does not need chemotherapy nor benefits from chemotherapy, as well as a high-risk score, which means that the patient clearly needs chemotherapy and certainly benefits from the chemotherapy. When it comes to the intermediate risk score, other factors will go into the decision-making process as far as the use of adjuvant chemotherapy or not. In estrogen receptor positive cancers, this is in both pre- and postmenopausal women, and this is certainly true with those who have up to 3 positive lymph nodes. It's an invaluable test leading to personalized treatment plans, and particularly the avoidance of unnecessary chemotherapy. The same is now true for ductal carcinoma in situ. The Oncotype test and DCIS is emerging as an important and validated tool to help us decide those patients who will benefit from adjuvant radiation therapy or not. If you've been diagnosed with stage 1 or stage 2 estrogen receptor positive breast cancer or with ductal carcinoma in situ, you need to know your Oncotype recurrence score.
Did you know that not every breast cancer patient needs chemotherapy? In fact, today, there's a way to identify whether or not you'd benefit from that chemotherapy based on the biology of your tumor. To learn more about the Oncotype DX assay and how to discuss the results with your physician, just press this button.